Hello students, welcome back again on the last part of that problem. That means journal entries. How will you do the journal entries? You see, it is given in page number 1.21. So go through it. I am explaining here. See, I have told you also earlier how to do the journal entries, but here it will be more clear. First item, you see from here, net profit. What is the amount of net profit? 4,92,000 in profit and loss appropriation account. Now, for that the journal entry is, I have told you that the items which will appear in the credit side of PL appropriation account, for that the PL appropriation account will be credited and the items which will appear, that will be debited, and vice versa here. Okay, let us check. So as it is appear in the credit side, so obviously the profit and loss appropriation account will be credited. Here you see, yes. See, profit and loss appropriation account is credit and the profit and loss account is debit. Clear? Next, B's salary account debit to B's current account. B's salary to B's current account. Why this B's current account? Why not capital account? As because the partners are maintaining the capital account under which method? Fixed method. That's why in each and every cases you will see current account will be there. Clear? So the amount of base salary 42,000 appear here. Next, I have told you that for some items you have to do two journal entries. That is interest on capital, commission, and these two, and salary, these three, debit side, and there is no interest on drawing. So two journal entries will come. First journal entry, B salary to B's current account. Then next journal entry, profit and loss appropriation account debit to B's salary. Likewise, this interest on capital account debit 1,20,000, the total interest. That means A's interest and B's interest to A's current account to B's current account. Then profit and loss appropriation account debit to interest on capital intact 1,20,000 will be there. Next, for commission of B, journal entry B's commission account debit to B's current account. That is 30,000 as you have calculated here. I have shown you earlier once again. Okay, I am showing. See, and the commission is here. So for that the journal entry is this. Then PL appropriation account debit to commission to be 30,000. And finally the divisible profit. Divisible profit, how much? You see, from PL appropriation account 2 lakh, 1 lakh, 2 lakh by A and 1 lakh by B. So for that the journal entry is profit and loss appropriation account debit to A's current account to B's current account. Simultaneously, if you will see the journal entries under fixed method and fluctuating method, then I think the matter will be more clear. You see, some items, some journal entries will remain constant. Now let us identify. Okay, this entry will remain constant as this is not affected the capital account of the partner or current account of the partner. And see, yes, this entry will also remain constant. Likewise, this entry will also remain constant. Next, this entry will also remain constant. Okay, now where and remaining entries, where you have written current account, in this particular case what you have to write, only you have to write capital account. So what you have learned from this journal entries, all the journal entries with this figure will remain constant. Only in state of current account we have to write capital account. Take this example, B's salary account debit 42,000, you will write, okay, to B's current account. Here you have to write B's capital account. Okay. Next example, interest on capital account debit to A's current account. Instead of A's current account, you will write A's capital account and B's capital account. In this manner, you have to do. So let us see. Turn the page. Yes. Page number 1.22. Go to the journal entry. Yes. See. Property. This is constant, I have told you. Okay. Next, you see B's salary account debit to what here is written? B's capital account instead of current account, B's capital account. Then PL appropriation account to B's salary, it is constant. Clear. Then interest on capital account debit to A's capital account instead of current account, A's capital account, B's capital account. So in this manner, all the journal entries is done here. Next, under fixed method, capital account, how will you prepare capital account? You see, in debits, in credit side, first you write by balance BD, the amount of capital which is given 10 lakhs of A and 10 lakhs of B. So as there is no further capital introduction, means additional capital is not there, and also permanent drawings or drawings out of capital is not there. So it is remain constant. 10 lakh opening balance as well as 10 lakh closing balance. So then, so all the loads now come to current account. See, the items which is appear in the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account, all that items appear in the credit side. By salary, B 42,000. By interest on capital, A 80,000. B 40,000. By commission, B 30,000. By profit and loss appropriation account, that is divisible profit. Likewise, this here you see two balance sheet. This means sum total of this side comes 2,80,000 and sum total of this side comes rupees 2,12,000. So as there is no item in the debit side, so the balance is remain constant. That means 2,80,000 for A and 2,12,000 for B. So in this manner, you have to prepare current account and capital account under fixed method. Now, how will you prepare capital account under fluctuating method? I have told you earlier also, again I repeat, say the balance first come here, okay? Then all the loads which is appear in the current account credit side, this will come directly to capital account. As you see here, salary B, interest on capital AB, commission B, divisible profit. Clear? And here you see balance. Clear? Balance. Sum total of this side is 12,80,000. So it will come here, and here 7,12,000 will come here. So in this manner, you have to prepare the capital account under fixed and fluctuating methods, and you have to do the journal entries in this manner. Now what you have to do, see this illustration, you will go through this illustration at your home first. Okay, illustration 9, then illustration 10, 11, 12, 10, then 11, 12, yes, till 12, sorry, till 13, till illustration 13, that means till page number 1.29, you will finish it, then you can solve the problem which are given in the exercise. We will dealt it with it later on. Okay, till then, okay, bye, have a nice day. Good morning, children. Today you will learn recording of partnership transaction. See, yes, page number 1.5. So open your book. So recording of transaction, the partnership business prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Clear? So this is the third stage of final account, as you have done in class 11, the final account of sole proprietorship business. As you have seen that trading account,
profit and loss account and balance sheet prepared by you. So now we have to prepare one more account that is called profit and loss appropriation account. So after preparation of trading account, you have prepared profit and loss account. So first stage is trading, second stage is profit and loss account, and the third stage is profit and loss appropriation account. So after preparation of profit and loss account, you have to prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Now, how you will prepare? I am explaining it from this format. Okay, all of you please open it. See, it will start. This is credit side. Okay, credit side. First item is buy profit and loss account. Net profit transfer from PL account. So the net profit which is given, that will come here. Okay. Next, interest on drawings. If interest on drawings is there, that will also comes in credit side. We have to write separately. Suppose two partners are there. A is interest on drawings, you will write here. B is interest on drawings, you will write here. Then you have done it earlier. Draw a line. Summation of these two will come to this column finally. So credit side, only these two items will come. And you see in the debit side, to salary of partners. So if any partners is getting any salary, that will be recorded here also. Like this, if two partners are getting the salaries, you have done it here like this. Here you have to do in this manner. Okay. So A is salary, A you will write inner column, B also write inner column. Then the sum total of salary will go to the outer column. Likewise, this commission of partners, same to interest on partners capital. Okay, so say AB, A interest on capital, you will write here, B here, then summation, go to that column. Then to reserve. Now what is this reserve? If the firm decided to not to distribute the whole profit between the partners, but want to keep some amount of profit as a reserve, then it will come in the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account. And finally, you see, to profit transfer to A's capital account or A's current account and B's capital account or B's current account. Now I am explaining why these two terms simultaneously used, capital account, current account. You will learn it later, but still I am telling you, the capital account, it is maintained in two methods. Okay, one is fixed method and another is fluctuating method. When the capital account maintained by the partners under fluctuating method, then only you have to write A's capital account, not current account, B's capital account, not current account. And if the capital account of the partners maintained under fixed method, then you have to write A's current account and B's current account. Now how you will do? After inserting all the items in debit and credit side, say, okay, these items, the balance which is come, that is to be called as divisible profit. Okay. And the balance which is come, that is to be distributed between the partners in their agreed profit sharing ratio. Now, if profit sharing ratio is not there, then it should be distributed between them in which ratio? Equally. You have learned it in previous video. In the absence of partnership debt, the profit or loss should be shared between the partners equally. In this manner, you have to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account. Okay. Now the journal entries, obviously, yeah, as this is a ledger, so ledger comes from journal. Now you have to pass the journal entries. See, journal entries, clearly it is written. Entry for transfer of net profit. Before you do the journal entry, I want to tell you the short theorem. How will you do? See, the items which will appear, you see here, the items which will appear in the credit side of profit and loss appropriation account, then what you have to do? Take this example. Which item appear here? Buy profit and loss account. What is this? This is net profit. So for it, what is the journal entry? The theory is item appear in the credit side. So obviously profit and loss appropriation account will be credited here. And the item which is appear, which item appear? profit and loss account, that should be debited. Got it? Likewise, this you can do it. See, interest on drawings. So what journal entry we will pass? Interest on drawings account debit to profit and loss appropriation account. In the debit side, just reverse the items which will appear in the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account. So obviously, profit and loss appropriation account will be debited, and the items which is appear, that should be credited. Take this example. So for this, salary to partner, okay. So profit and loss appropriation account debit to salary of partners, okay. In this manner, you have to do the journal entries are here. Now, see, for I am telling, so for some items which are appear in debit and credit side, for some items you have to give only one journal entry. For example, this I am telling, please note it down. Net profit, this item only one journal entry will come, clear? Then you say reserve, only one journal entry will come. Then net divisible profit, for this one journal entry come. And for others means remaining item, that means interest on drawings, two journal entries. Then salary of partners, two journal entries. Commission of partners, that is also in this case two journal entries. Interest on partners capital, two journal entries. Now one entry is transferring entry, transfer to profit and loss appropriation account, and another is, see here, you see entry for transfer net profit to profit and loss appropriation account, only one journal entry is there. As you have done it, I have told you profit and loss account debit to profit and loss appropriation account. See, now see, interest on capital, for this two journal entries are there. Number one, Roman one, on allowing interest on capital. So interest on capital account debit to partners capital account, clear? If it is maintained under fluctuating method, if it is maintained under fixed method, then it should be partners current account. Point to be noted. I repeat, first journal entry, allowing interest on capital, interest on capital account debit to partners capital account. You will write capital account. If the capital account is maintained under fluctuating method, then you will write partners capital account, okay. And if it is maintained under fixed method, then you have to write here partners current account. Now if you take this example, if two partners are there, you see here AB, okay. Now come here, then how you will write it? I am telling, interest on capital account debit to A's capital account to B's capital account. In this manner you have to write, do not write partners capital account. Point to be noted. Again I repeat, interest on capital account debit, suppose A is getting 4000 interest and B is getting 1000 interest, then how will you write? Interest on capital account debit, A plus B, that is 5000 will come in debit side here, okay, debit. Then to A's capital account, in credit side you have to write here 4000, then to B's capital account 1000. In this manner you have to do the journal entries. You see in next page, see the, I have told you two entry, you have to pass two entry. See another entry for interest on capital, on closure of interest on capital. So note it down, this is called closing entry. Sometimes in the question paper it is given, pass the closing entry, then you have to write only this entry, profit and loss appropriation account debit to interest on capital. Here intact interest on capital, that is 5000 will come. Point to be noted. Profit and loss appropriation account debit 5000, as I have given you that instance that A's interest is 4000 and B's interest is 1000. So 5000 will be debited here, and interest on capital also 5000 will be credited here. Now take another example of credit side of, see credit side, interest on drawings AB. Suppose A's interest is 500 and B's interest is 400. So total interest, yeah, here you have to write A's interest 500, B's interest 400, sum total 900 will come here. Now, how will you journalize this? Say the example here I am showing you. Say, here also two entries will come. First, say, entry for interest on drawings. On charging interest on drawings. Partner's capital account debit to interest on drawings, it is written. But you have to write how? I am telling you. Listen, partner's capital, instead of partner's capital account, you have to write A's capital account debit if it is fluctuating, and B's capital account debit fluctuating. A's capital account debit how much? 500, and B's capital account debit 400, to interest on drawings 900. Clear? And in second entry, what you will do? For closer, again the closing entry, for interest on drawings account debit to profit and loss appropriation account intact 900. So in this manner you have to do this journal entry, go through the books. I hope that you can easily understand. So if there is any problems or doubt, you can ask me when the school will reopen, or you can send your doubts to Success Father WhatsApp, then he will convey it to me, because I don't have any phone number, children. So next topics is distinction between profit and loss account and profit and loss appropriation account. Here you can easily find out. Okay, no problem, I hope so. Because what is the difference, as I have told you, PL appropriation account, that is the third stage of final account of partnership business, and profit and loss account, this is the second stage. So here it is given, if you go through it, I hope that it will be understood by you. Similarly, charge against profit and charge against appropriation of profit. What is the charge against profit means? The items which will debited to profit and loss account, these items are called charge against profit. And the items which will debited to profit and loss appropriation account, that is called appropriation of profit. That is the short theory I am telling. Now, see, in PL appropriation account, what you have learned, you have seen that all the items related to partners only, that is partner's salary, partner's commission, partner's interest on capital, partner's interest on drawings, that will comes in PL appropriation account. So these are called appropriation of profit. That means indirectly the profits are distributed, except in case of interest on drawings, in case of salary, in case of commission, in case of interest on capital, indirectly the profit are distributed to the partner. Clear? And in one item is most important, I am telling, please listen to me very carefully, that is interest on loan of partner. Interest on loan of partner, it should be debited to profit and loss account, because it is considered as charge against profit. It is not the appropriation of profit. Okay. So next video I will send you regarding how will you dealt with the appropriation item when the profits is not sufficient and profit is sufficient also. Okay. Till then. Okay. Bye bye. Have a nice day.
Hello children. Welcome back again. Now we will learn how the partnership firm maintain their capital account. As in last video I have told you, there are two methods for preparation of capital account. You see, one is fixed capital account and another is fluctuating capital account. Now under fixed capital account, what you have to do, consider the capital in the capital account and other load to the current account. Here, see the format. Capital account, which type of items are appear in the capital account. Suppose there are three partners, partner A, B, C. So you will draw this format. First particulars, A, B, C, three columns. Then again particulars, A, B, C, three columns. This is debit side, and you see this is credit side. Now the first item which will appear in the capital account is by balance BD. By balance BD means the opening capital which is given. Clear? Now how will you identify the capital is opening or not? If only capital is there, there is no debt, no further information, then that is to be considered as opening capital. Otherwise, the debt will be given. Suppose A, B, C are partners. They introduce capital rupees this much, this much, this much. That is also considered as opening capital. Unless and until it is mentioned in the questions that this is the closing capital or the book closer of accounts, that closing date is given and the capital are given, or adjusted capital, then it is to be considered as opening capital. Clear? As you have learned, if adjusted capital given, how will you find out opening capital? So read the question paper carefully and also see the nature of the capital, which type of capital is there, whether it is opening or it is closing. So first item is opening capital. Then which item will appear in the credit side? Additional capital. If further or additional capital introduced, then that will appear in the credit side by writing cash or bank. Then in debit side, you see two cash and bank. If the drawings against capital or permanent withdrawal of capital, clear? If that type of drawings is there, then it will comes to debit side, and then you have to find out the closing balance, that is CD. I hope that it is clear to you. Now from this discussion, if I will ask you, the fixed capital will remain fixed, yes or no? The answer is, it may be changed. It will depend on some circumstances. Now, under which circumstances the fixed capital may change? The answer is, if there is any additional capital introduced, or if there is any drawings made out of capital, then the fixed capital may be changed. Take one example. Suppose capital of ABC 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh. If no further introduction of additional capital, if no further drawings made, then obviously the CD, the closing balance will remain same. 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh. But if additional capital introduced by the partners, 50,000, 30,000, 20,000, and the drawings made by them, 5,000, 5,000, 5,000, then automatically the closing balance will change. It will not remain 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh. I hope that it is clear to you. Now, current account, which type of items will appear? From PL appropriation account debit side, the items which you have written, interest on capital, it will come, partner salary, it will come, commission, it will come, and divisible profit, the net profit, that will come to credit side. And by balance BD, this is the opening balance of current account. Point to be noted. If opening balance of current account is given, current account balance only is given, that is to be considered as favorable balance, and it will appear in the credit side. Unless and until it is mentioned, the current account balance is debit balance. Now, if debit balance is there, then obviously it will appear to this side. To balance BD, A, B, C, you will write here the current account debit balance. Then which items will come here? To drawings. Drawings against profit. So what you have learned? There are two types of drawings made. Drawings out of capital and drawings out of profit. Drawings out of capital will appear to which account? Capital account under fixed method. Clear? Drawings out of capital and drawings out of profit will come to current account. Do not misguide yourself. Okay. Next, interest on drawings and profit and loss account, that share of loss in case of loss, if loss is there. Then after that, you have to find out the closing balance. If credit side is higher, the total of credit side is higher, then the obviously the balance will come to debit side. You will write to balance CD. And if the total of debit side is higher than credit side, then the balance will come to credit side and you have to write by balance CD. So this is, in this way you have to prepare the capital account as well as current account under fixed method. Now fluctuating method capital account, the combination of these two means the items which you have written over here. Okay, take the example interest on capital, partner salary, partner's commission, divisible profit, that will appear to the credit side of capital account and these items will appear to debit side. So there is no questions arise for current account. As you see the format over here, capital account when capitals are fluctuating. ABC, by balance BD, first opening capital come, then cash bank, additional capital come, then you see interest on capital. In previous case we have considered here interest on capital, you see in the current account, but now as the partners are maintaining the capital account under fluctuating method, so it is appear in the credit side of which account? See, capital account. Interest on capital, partner salary, partner's commission and divisible profit. So all will come to the credit side. So what you have learned, the load of capital account go to capital account instead of being it will come in current account. These are the items. Interest on capital, partner salary, partner's commission and divisible profit. It will come directly to capital account. And here you see, to cash and bank, drawings against capital, to drawings against profit. So both the drawings will come here. If the drawings made out of capital, then you have to write to cash and banks, cash oblique bank, or if it is out of profit, then you will write to drawings. To interest on drawings, to profit and loss, share of loss, and finally, the balance comes. So this debit side items, all the items except this bidding will appear here. Now same procedure you have to follow to find out the balance. If credit side is higher, this total is higher than debit side total, then the balance come to this side. Okay, ABC and vice versa. Means if the debit side total, these totals are higher than the credit side total, then the obviously the balance will come to this side. In this manner you have to find out or you have to prepare the capital account. Okay, now let us see one example where you can see. So all of you are giving instruction to open page number 1.20, illustration 8. Okay, I am reading the problem. I hope that all of you will take your book. See, AB are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 2:1. So profit sharing ratio is given with capitals of 10 lakhs, 5 lakhs respectively on 1st April 2019. Each partner is entitled to 8% interest on his capital. So you have to find out the interest on capital. A's interest will be 10 lakhs into 8 by 100, that is 80,000. And B's interest will be 5 lakhs into 8 by 100, it will be 40,000. Then B is entitled to a salary of rupees 3,500 per month. See, it's salary given to B per month. So you have to convert it into annual salary. Means you have to multiply this figure by 12 while solving the problem. Together with a commission of 10% of net profit. Read this language carefully. Commission of 10% of net profit remaining after deducting interest on capitals. So after deducting the interest on capital, the profit which is left and salary also you have to deduct the salary, and after charging his commission, please underline this line, after charging his commission, as you have done in class 11 manager's commission. Here you have to apply the same formula, that means profit before charging his commission into rate by rate plus 100. In this manner you have to find out the commission. I will explain it Okay. The profit for the year ended 31st March 2020 prior to, please underline this word, prior to calculation of interest on capital, but after charging salary of B. That means the profit which is given from here, the B salary already charged, means already considered, but interest on capital not yet considered. Clear? 4,50,000. Now, so the division of profit means you have to prepare profit and loss appropriation account, pass journal entries and prepare partner's capital account when it is fixed and when it is fluctuating, means fluctuating and fixed capital method. Now, see, how will you solve this problem? So, first, you see the status or nature of the net profit which is given, that is 4,50,000. It comes after, see what is written, after charging salary of B, B's salary. Now, what is the amount of B's salary? B is getting salary how much? 3,500 per month and multiplied by 12. If you multiplied it by 12, then 36,000 plus 6,000. So, it becomes 42,000. So, as this salary is already charged, so you have to add back this salary with the net profit to find out the actual profit. Here you see. What is the amount of net profit given? 4,50,000 plus 42,000 B's salary. The total amount come, you see here. Yes, 4,92,000. Clear? Now again I repeat, why we are adding this figure, 42,000 B salary. This 42,000 comes 3,500 per month into 12. That is 42,000. Why we are adding this? As because this is already charged, already considered. Clear? So as the volume of profit is deteriorated, that's why we have to enhance the volume of profit. That's why we are adding this. So read the language carefully. Main status of net profit after charging or before charging item is there, then you have to adjust in this manner. Now before charging interest on capital is there, so it will not create any problem, it will come directly. Now see, B salary once we add over here, again we have to show here to B salary, okay, then interest on capital, as I have told you, A 80,000, B 40,000, sum total is 1,20,000. To commission to BC, note 1, how the commission is calculated. Okay, so go to here. Calculation of partner's commission. So the net profit is 4,50,000 minus interest on capital 1,20,000. It becomes 3,30,000. I have told you the formula in class 11. See, same formula. 3,30,000 profit before charging commission into rate by rate plus 100. Rate is 10. 10%, 10 by 100 plus 10, 110. So it is 30,000. Now why we consider this 10 by 110? Because only for this, again I go to the problem, you say here, after charging his commission, again I repeat, please underline it properly, after charging his commission, that means after charging his commission, the profit, what will come? On that profit, he will get the commission 10%. Okay, that's why this formula is applicable here. Now, if you want to check it, I am telling. Now, see, his commission is comes at 30,000. Now, after charging his commission, considering his commission, the profit is 3,30,000. Now, if you deduct after charging his commission, means the profit, how much profit will left? 3,30,000 minus 30,000, it will be 3 lakhs. Now, if you calculate 10% commission on 3 lakhs, it becomes 30,000. This is the checkpoint you can use whether you are correct or not. Then after getting this figure, you insert here to base commission 30,000. Then you see, I have told you as credit side is higher, total is 4,92,000, and debit side, if you do the total, this 1 lakh 20 plus 42, that is 1,62,000 plus 30, 1,92,000 is the debit side total. So as credit side is higher than debit side, then the balance will come to debit side and it is called divisible profit. How much? 3 lakhs. Now this 3 lakhs is to be distributed between A and B, okay, in their agreed profit sharing ratio. You see in the questions, what is the profit sharing ratio? 2:1. So 3 lakhs, see, 3 lakhs into 2/3, that will be the share of A, and 3 lakh into 1/3, that will be the share of B. In this manner, you have to distribute the profit, it will come here, okay. So, now, next video you will learn how you will generalize this and how will you maintain the capital account under fixed and fluctuating method. Till then, bye-bye.